G'day YouTube, 49's Fine Silver here. G'day YouTube. For those of you who know me, you know that I have broken my last crucible, and so today I'm going to make a new one. I've got a video in the video section that shows you how to build one type of crucible. But today's crucible is going to be a quicker and easier one. So what I've done is gone down to the local nursery and I've picked up a bag of crushed limestone. It's pretty cheap, but crushed limestone. So I've got 3 cups of crushed limestone. The reason I've got 3, I want to try and make the crucible up in this old fertilizer container. And I've got 1.5 cups of plaster of Paris. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add those to this plastic bag because I couldn't be bothered mixing. I find that just adding it to a plastic bag makes it really easy to deal with. I've got a plane coming over, so hang in there. I add the dry ingredients together. Give them a pretty good mix. Through the plastic bag too, it's easy to see whether you've got it nicely mixed or not. So, try not to spill it. Alright, now that that's mixed, what I want to do is add the water. Alright, so We want to add the water. I'm not sure exactly how much water to add at this point, so I'm just putting in a bit. It's not an exact recipe at this stage. All right. Now that that's mixed through, I want to add it to my container. It doesn't matter if it leaks over, I've got a catchment there. Alright, we'll put that aside. Alright, we'll just give that a bit of a shake through. Okay, what I want to do now is I'm going to add a plastic ball to it, but you've got to make sure that the plastic ball you're going to use is smooth. So when you add it, I'll put it in and flood it over. It seems a little bit wet at the moment, but that's okay. And what I've got here is I've got my old crucible that was broken, and it's exactly the same shape. So what I'm going to do is add that to there. That'll hold it down for me. If you can prop it up, do whatever you've got to do. But that will dry in not very long from now. So what I'll do is I'll put that aside. I'll dry my hands off a bit, and what I'll do is I'll show you the one that I made about a week ago, and there it is. Now that we've got that, what we've got to do is we've got to prepare the crucible. Make sure you've let it dry for at least a week, because if you don't, it starts steaming, it carries on, and then it'll start cracking anyway. So the drier it is, the better. So now that you've got to that level, it's time to prepare it. Now how we prepare it is, we're going to get the torch out, we're going to heat it until it's nice and hot, and then I'm going to add some of this borax Now you can use any type of borax. This is just one I picked up from the supermarket. Again, pretty cheaply. Doesn't matter if it's scented or anything like that, as long as it's borax powder. All right, let's get into it. Okay guys, this will be a bit noisy. I've got to get my torch going. So if you need to turn down the volume, feel free. Okay. I'll try and put it on not too heavy so you can still hear. Alright, what we're going to do is we're going to heat up the crucible until it's hot. Starting to glow a little bit red now. That's what we're hoping for. And there's a few different ways you can do this. You can add a whole heap of borax into the middle and just swirl it around gently. Or you can sprinkle it on evenly. I probably like the swirling around. But before you do that, it's probably best to try and get it on as evenly as you can. So. All you do is you just pick up a pinch in your hand and just sprinkle it on gently. And then try not to blow it all off. So, and this could take a little while to do. So just take your time. You're in no rush anyway. The best job is normally take a little bit of time. So once it's all gone, do it again. Start to see it turning like honey inside. See the difference. The inside, you're starting to get that honey look. As it gets thicker, you can start to turn it, it'll actually run inside. and you can slowly but surely turn your crucible gently and run it all the way around the edges. You can even get too much in there and run it out if you want to. You see how it's all bubbly and nice? That's what you're looking for. You want that even all over the whole crucible. So what we're hoping for now is a nice, even, smooth glaze all over the whole thing. And that's it. You've got your crucible prepared, and now you're ready to melt some silver in it. So what I'll do is I'll go and prepare a mold, and I think I might try and get this little bear just here. Now you've seen me pack molds many times and the video's going a bit long already, so I'll prepare it, we'll melt some silver, and then I'll put you back on once the silver's melted into my crucible and we'll give it a go. Righto, hang on. So that's it from me, so don't forget to like, comment and subscribe.